Hey guys, what's up? It's your girl Faye Lene back with another video. If you are new here, welcome. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. I really hope that you enjoy. If you do, be sure to give it a big thumbs up and also be sure to join the fam by clicking on the subscribe button down below. And if you are not new here, you guys already know what it is. So thank you so much for coming back for another video. So for today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to recreate this supernatural everyday makeup look. You can of course recreate it with or without the lashes, but I'm going to be filming a couple of other videos today, so I figured I would throw on some lashes. And I also wanted to show you guys how it would look with the lashes for those of you guys that might have lash extensions or just like to wear lashes on an everyday basis. So this look is of course perfect for everyday wear, whether that be school or work or just to run errands, just on a day-to-day basis where you want to kind of do a little something but you don't want to be full-on glam. This is pretty much my everyday makeup look for going to work, with the exception of the lashes. I normally don't throw on lashes for work, but outside of that, this is pretty much my everyday routine. And I also included all drugstore products for this video, so if you are a beauty on a budget, this one is for you, girl. I made sure to include lots of affordable products that you can actually go to your drugstore and purchase, not just affordable products that you have to order online. I tried to really make sure that I use products that you can actually go to your store and purchase. So yeah, that is all that I have for you guys for this intro. If you would like to see how to recreate this look, then please keep watching. To start off this look, I'm going to prime the face, and the first thing that I'm using is the e.l.f. Oil Control Primer Mist. I'm just going to spray that all over my face, and then to smooth my skin, I'm using the CoverGirl Smoothing Primer. I have absolutely been loving this primer. I've been using it a ton and have mentioned it in several of my previous videos. It's really, really good. And then after that, for oil control, I'm going to use the NYX Angel Veil. If you guys watch my videos, you guys know I absolutely love the Hourglass Mineral Veil, and this is a really good dupe for that primer, and it does a great job of controlling oil throughout the day. And then after that, I'm going in with this Rimmel Loose Setting Powder. This one is a mattifying powder, and I'm just going to apply that in the areas that I tend to get the most oily to set my primers and just help my foundation to last a little bit longer throughout the day. With the power of editing, I'm going to go ahead and fill in my brows. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. And then I'm going to go in with foundation. So you guys have been hearing me raving about this foundation, and for good reason. It is so good to be a drugstore product. This is the LA Girl Pro Matte HD Foundation. You guys, if you don't have this foundation, you need it in your life. It is so good. So I'm just applying this with a Morphe brush and just stippling and blending that out all over the skin. And then after I have that applied, I'm gonna go in with a second layer. As you guys can see, I'm literally scraping the bottle. I am obsessed with this foundation, but I'm just gonna apply a little bit extra on my cheek area because I tend to need a little bit of extra coverage there. And as you guys can see, it builds beautifully. It doesn't get cakey and it just looks flawless. I'm obsessed with it. So after that, for concealer, I'm going in with these by Makeup Revolution. I will have the shades listed for you guys down below, but I believe this one is the shade 10, maybe. But like I said, I'll have the shades listed below, and I like to use the darker one all over the face, and then I'll go in with the lighter one just in the inner corners of my eyes, which you guys will see me do in just a second, right here. I like to go in with the lighter one just on the inner corners, just to kind of brighten that area, because I do have a little bit of darkness right in the inner corners of my eyes. So I'm gonna go in with my Beauty Blender and just blend all of that out. My Beauty Blender is damp. It is not soaking wet, but it is damp. And I do prefer to use my Beauty Blender that way. Most of you guys probably already know that trick with using your Beauty Blender damp. But just in case you don't, I just wanted to go ahead and mention it. And as you can see, I'm just going in and blending all of that concealer out around the nose and also onto my eyelid to prime my lids. And then to set the concealer, I'm going in with this Fit Me Loose Powder from Maybelline. These are also really good, you guys, and they have several different shades. I'm not sure exactly how many shades, but these little loose powders are really good, and they're great if you want a little bit of extra coverage from your loose powder. These are just bomb. So I'm applying that all over where I applied the concealer, as well as right up underneath where I'm going to contour. I did let it bake for just a little bit, and here I'm just going in and sweeping away the extra powder. And then after that, I'm gonna go in with the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Powder. This one is in the shade Caramel, I believe. But like I said, I will have all of the products and shades listed for you guys down below in the description. But I'm just going to set the rest of my face, bring a little bit of that color back into my skin, because that loose setting powder does kind of ghost me out a little bit. So I'm just going to set the rest of my foundation and bring a little bit of that color back. And then to help bring a little shape and contour and shadow back to my face, I'm going to bronze with the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. This one is in the shade Deep Bronze, and I'm just using this with a Morphe bronzer brush and just applying that on the hollows of my cheeks, my forehead, all of the regular places that I would typically bronze the skin. And then following that, I'm going in with the L'Oreal Lumi Bronze It Bronzer. This one is the Deep Bronzer, and I'm just using that to kind of chisel it out a little bit more, give me a little bit more shape, a little bit more definition. This is definitely an optional step, but just wanted to show you guys in case you're interested in a full beat, okay? And then for blush, I'm going in with the NYX blush in the shade Amber. And I'm just applying that to the apples of my cheeks and blending it back into the bronzer. And then I'm going to set everything in place with the L'Oreal Infallible Mist Setting Spray. So for highlighter, I'm going in with this L'Oreal Metallic Foiled Highlighter, which is beautiful. This one is in the shade Rose Quartz. And I'm just applying this to my cheekbones, to my nose, to my cupid's bow. And then I'm just going to blend it out again with my blush brush just to make sure that everything blends nice and seamlessly. So next up, I'm going in with the Profusion Naturals Palette. And guys, I'm not doing anything major with my eyes, so don't get nervous. I'm literally going in with two shades. This one is a warm, natural transition shade. I'm just buffing this into the crease just to give my eyes a little bit of dimension. And then after that, I'm going to go in with a little bit more of a reddish tone shade, slightly darker than the one that I just used, and I'm going to apply that on the lower lash line just to kind of give my lower lash line a little bit of shape as well. And then once I'm done with that, I'm going to go in with the Maybelline Big Shot Times Shayla Mascara and a super thin line on my upper lash line. So as you can see, you can totally leave it like this, or you can add some lashes. So in this case, I wanted to show you guys what it looked like both with the natural lashes as well as if you wanted to add a little bit of an extra lash. And then here I'm going back in with the same highlighter that I used on my cheekbones and applying that to my inner corner just to really open up the eye. So to complete the look, I'm going in with ColourPop's BFF3 Lip Liner, and then I'm going to go right on top of that with L'Oreal's Infallible Lip Paint in the shade Nude. And I did decide to go with a glossy finish because I do feel like it just gives the overall look a much more youthful and fresh face feel to it. And yeah, once you have your lip applied, that is going to complete this look. Alright guys, so once again, this is the finished look. I really hope that you guys enjoyed seeing me create a super natural, super easy, everyday makeup look using all drugstore and affordable products. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know down below in the comments what your favorite drugstore products are. As you guys know, I do have oily skin, so if you have any suggestions of products that are good for oily skin, feel free to leave those for me down below in the comments. All of the products that I use throughout the video will be listed for you guys down below in the description box as well. And yeah, that's pretty much all that I have for you for this video. So I really hope that you enjoyed. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you very soon in my next one.